Hi guys, so welcome to Olenko's Kitchen. Today is December 12th, and actually today is my name's day. We celebrate this in Poland. It's the birthday of your name. So my name is Alexandra, so December 12th, it's my name's day. So it's cool that actually, came on that, it's the same day than the live streaming. So I'm gonna make some yummy food today for you. But first, what I wanna say, thank you so much for watching. And if you think that this information can benefit someone, you can please share this video on your page so your friends can watch it. And of course, if you have any questions about me and about being, following a raw vegan diet and plant-based diet and anything, you can, post them and I'll be tracking them and trying to, answering them. The way live streaming works on Facebook is a little bit delayed, so I'm gonna try to do my best, and of course later I will be answering all your questions for sure. So today actually all the recipes that I'm making are from my cookbook Raw Food Art. So for those who are wondering, what to get maybe for someone that has everything and you don't know what to get for someone, this book, it's $29.99. You can buy it on Barnes & Noble or Amazon. It's a great gift. You have over 80 recipes. Let me just over 80 recipes based on four seasons, and I walk you through it. How to start, plant-based diet, raw vegan diet. And today we're going to be making pasta italiana, which is one of my favorite recipes. And I'm actually there are many pasta recipes in my book, so I'm gonna show you how easy you can make pasta from zucchini or squash, or you can even use carrots or cucumbers or even sweet potatoes. But today I'm gonna be using actually organic green squash. I'm gonna be also making today my favorite dessert because it's my name's day. So durian pudding. So I got some durian at H Mart, and also we're going to be making my other favorite dessert, which are brownies. They are so good, and they're very low fat, and because they come in the cashew brownies, because they come you put them in the dehydrator and the next day you have delicious brownies. But I don't have any cashews. Actually, I'm low on cashews, so actually I'm going to be using almond meal. But this is what I want to show you, that many times when you're cooking, you can't really follow the recipe, so you can easily substitute a lot of things. So if the recipe calls for, I don't know, pinoli nuts, you can use some pecans or you can use some walnuts. So it's not a problem. You can always easily substitute, because I know that many of you live in different part of the world, and some things are seasonal and some things are hard to get. So you can always experiment, and that's what is the best thing about a raw diet, that you can't burn anything because we're not using any oven, we're not using any stove, we're just basically mixing and blending and using the dehydrator, which is very, very low temperature. And for those who this is my fourth raw vegan cooking class here on Facebook, but for those who are joining first time, thank you so much for watching. And just a little bit about me. So I'm an artist, I'm an art educator, I'm a health coach, and I've been cooking basically like all my life since I've been 5 years old. I'm originally from Poland. If you hear my accent and you're wondering where I'm from, now I live in New York. And yeah, that's about it. And I love sharing my passion for healthy living. And yeah, that's about it. Let me see if anybody's has any questions. Oh boy, there is my cat. Of course, she's back. Kija, come on. This is my cat, Kija. Come on. Who loves raw diet. So these are her favorite, the nori wraps. She loves spinach and cucumbers. For those who've seen it, I don't want her to be jumping on the counters, but yeah, she wants seaweed. Do you want seaweed, Kija? Yes. So here, I'm gonna give you a lot of seaweed so you're not bothering me. Oh, let me just go outside of the kitchen. Come, Kija. But Nori sheets are great. You can use them for wraps. You can like wrap your favorite food. You can put them in the salads. You can put it in the soup. So this is great substitute. And next week, I think I'm going to be showing you actually how to make wraps because I got a lot of requests. I'm going to be also showing you how to do sprouting in the kitchen. And I'm going to have my friend visiting probably Monday morning. And she's Korean. And we're going to be making some kimchi and some different fermented food because Korean cuisine has a lot of fermented food. So I may do maybe even two streaming classes that day or just one in the morning, but I don't know how this is gonna work. And also next week, I'm gonna, just before Christmas, I'm gonna be doing another live streaming and I'm gonna be showing you how to make my favorite cookies, gingerbread cookies from my cookbook, and how to make a beautiful Christmas tree, edible Christmas tree that you can actually bring to a Christmas gathering, or even if you don't celebrate Christmas, you can make a different you know, kind of edible sculpture, because you know our cooking is about having fun, and it's like art, you know, creating, having mess and experimenting. And yeah, so don't feel bad if you, you know, don't have some ingredients. You can always substitute. It's very easy. I'm gonna show you. And for those who know, I love supporting local farmers. So before I start cooking, I want to show you. So on Friday, I got this beautiful fruits from Miami Fruits in Florida. I mean, Miami Fruits in Florida, because last week I said Miami Fruits here. I said Florida fruits, but they, this is an organic farm and they have amazing, amazing fruits. So let me show you. I got some mama zapote, which is not ready. I got some delicious baby bananas, egg fruit, which is amazing. My husband wasn't very happy about it, but I loved it. Some rambutans, of course, some passion fruit. I don't know if I can take it out. But all these, you know, beautiful fruits from Florida, and of course some dragon fruits. For those who never tried dragon fruit, it comes in white and it comes in pink. So when you cut it, it has like spots. It's really, really awesome. And this really looks beautiful when you're doing some kind of arrangement. So I just wanted to show it to you. Oh, and I've got a huge avocado. Look at the size of this amazing avocado. Because avocado is actually not a vegetable. It's actually a fruit and actually a berry family. But again, if you don't know what to buy for this person that maybe has everything, maybe a fruit basket from Miami Fruit will be a perfect gift for someone that you know, that you want them to try and be healthy. So, okay, so let me just put this here and start cooking. So this is my dehydrator. Let's see if anybody's asking any questions. No questions yet. Don't be shy, guys. Say hi if you're watching. And you can even post it where you're from. That would be really, really cool. And yeah, so today I'm going to be making, the first thing is pasta italiana. So this is Spirali Maker. So this little tool, it's great. You can make so many different kinds of pastas, which are low fat. I know some people like to like use the raw pasta and then they cook it or steam it very quickly. I love to eat it raw because when you have baby veggies, they, you know, it's so soft. And what's the best about this, you make the pasta and you can, you know, keep it like for a few days in the fridge, and then the next day just make a sauce in your, you know, Vitamix or high speed blender. So this is another tool that I really recommend if you are serious about raw vegan cooking. And yeah, so it's really, really cool. You can buy it in Bad Betty Beyond, and they also have like a little one, like a hand blender, like a hand pasta maker. I never tried that one, but I've heard it gets sometimes stuck. So this is very easy. Comes in, you have different sizes. Let me show you. So comes in different sizes. So I'm going to be using the smaller one, and also has a blade that you can just slice something. So I already washed my squash, organic squash. Let me just cut the ends. And thank you so much for watching. I know this is a very busy time of the year, but seems like Monday night is pretty good night for me because I don't work on Monday, so I don't have to like rush from work and trying to do this streaming. Many times when you buy food, it has stickers. And so I don't just peel the stickers. I actually cut them off because I don't want to be ingesting, this. God knows what they put, what kind of things. Keisha, you back? It's not a good idea. So okay, so I don't know if I'm gonna use all of them. If you really want it to look like pasta, you can peel the squash or the zucchini, but mostly the most vitamins are in the skin, so I'm gonna use it. Like I don't care if it has green, but if you really want it to look like pasta, you could do this, and then then the noodle's gonna look exactly like pasta. So let me just wash my hands. Let's see if anybody's asking questions. Oh, people are asking. Oh, see, Facebook streaming so like delayed. I didn't even see that people are asking questions. So, hi guys, hi Lydia, hi Sandra, Iana, Michelle, hi. And you're saying that you love dragon fruits. Let me see. Okay, Bill is keeping track on all the technical stuff. Yeah, if you get like little stuck, that's Facebook, so you may have to refresh or do a different browser because some browsers are slower. Okay, come, Keisha. My cat is just out of control. Come on, Keisha. I'm just washing my hands so my hands are nice and clean. So now I'm gonna be making the pasta. And talking about cats, so we just had last week was very stressful. We had an emergency with our other cat, Sushi, who swallowed a toy, and he had pancreatitis, and we had to take him to a vet, and he had to be at the vet over for 2 days. It was very, very scary, but he's okay. So thanks, big thanks to Nahara and her team, and yeah, we are so grateful. So see, is it coming? Yeah, you know what? I'm doing this. I have to move it. I don't know if it's gonna, because I'm right-handed. Yeah, see, I couldn't turn it, but now you don't see it. Hold on. I had it here, so hold on. So thank God for the amazing vet, and actually she's a holistic vet, which they use all different natural holistic approaches like acupuncture, herbs, and vitamins and enzymes, and of course they use regular medication too if necessary, and of course they do surgeries. But yeah, we didn't have to do surgery, which was amazing. But yeah, so huge thanks. So look at this yum, beautiful pasta. It really looks like pasta. Can you see it? She's up to no good, so maybe you want to take her because I. You want to say hi or no? Okay, so. So put some pants. My husband is funny. No, he has pants, but he has like sweatpants, so. He wants to, I guess, looks nice. But yeah, look at this beautiful pasta. So here I have a nice big bowl. I'm gonna be transferring. So any questions, guys? Who has this? Whoever tried raw pasta? My favorite. I actually have a few recipes in my book. I have some pasta, summer pasta with mango sauce, which is amazing. See, she's. Come on. Come on. Come on, Keisha. Sorry, it's just I can't be dealing with her because I think she needs an attention. So, because I guess she wasn't getting much attention because her brother was sick. But I have these leftover guys, so I just put them on the side. Okay, so I'm gonna use this zucchini. People are responding that you tried pasta many times. Yeah, it's so this is really great substitute for someone who is gluten free and trying not to eat gluten, or someone who is trying to lose maybe extra weight. So now is holiday time, holiday seasons. We're going for a lot of parties, and when you're eating a bowl of this kind of pasta at home, and when you go for the party, you're not gonna feel bad that you're splurging on something because this is so healthy. See, I have to hold on, I have to move it a little bit. So this is a great. Let's see. This is really a great substitute. My mom, she has a huge garden in Poland, and the zucchinis that she grows, they're like huge. Oh my God. And she makes this amazing meal. Like, it's with tomatoes and peppers and onions, all from the garden. But yeah, so for this, you want to use baby squash or baby zucchini, because you don't want to have the pits. Otherwise, when they grow big, you're going to have the pits. So you want them to be nice and soft. You can make this with pesto sauce. And also, in my book, I have a recipe for raw lasagna, which will be very similar. And you could, so basically, it's a little bit different recipe, but you can just make it, slice it, or use mandolin, which is like a tool that you slice it very thin, your pasta. I think I'm gonna make it for Christmas Eve next week. Then I'm going, because I'm gonna prepare it when you slice the zucchini and you put it in a dish, like a glass dish, like this, and you bring it to, and you layer it, and then the next day you wanna bring it a few hours later to a party. All the flavors go through it and it tastes amazing. So sometimes even the pasta tastes better. So let's see. I'm so excited for durian pudding. And I know a lot of people are asking, and telling me, actually not even asking, that yes, but I can't afford organic food. Organic food is very expensive. And hold on, I may have to do this way. But obesity and diabetes, number two, type two, it's a huge problem, especially in the United States. I work with kids. I'm a teacher. I teach art, and it's just, and I know I have a lot of friends who are teachers too, and like the food that they serve in cafeteria is just so much processed food. And they even have, vending machines with like soda and all this junk food, because actually these companies give money into, to each state, and help, pay for schools. But then kids, of course they want to buy junk food. And it's not something that, like you saying, my kids are not going to be eating this because, they don't like this kind of pasta. I'm Italian, I like just regular pasta. But try here a little bit and a little bit, and trust me, my parents in Poland, my mother used to bake. We had candies, on the counter. I was never a candy eater. I never even liked the desserts, because we had a huge garden. My grandparents were farmers, and we had all these fresh fruits and vegetables. And since young age, I was just eating, that was just like my food that I was used to it. So you don't have to limit yourself. But when you actually, try all this delicious food, like from Mother Nature, and process real food, you're not gonna be craving this, this junk food and everything. Hold on. Is this going? I think that's pretty. I don't know if I'm gonna be using all of the zucchinis. I think that's pretty good. Let me just finish this. So if I was going to like make it extra, probably I will make the sauce and mix with pasta, or if you want to even keep it for like 2 days or something, you just don't mix it, and then you can make the sauce like later. With raw food, yeah, I will say you probably don't want to keep anything longer than like 3 days because it's raw, so you don't want the bacteria to to the bad bacteria, because you have good bacteria like in fermented food and probiotic and yogurt, but in we don't want to be eating bad bacteria. So with everything, like when you cut the apple and like minute later you're gonna see it start turning brown because it oxidizes. So that's what happened, is it's just the nature doing its things. The oxygen, it's starting aging. So that's what happened to us. We age, and that's why we really need to eat like fresh, real food, not processed food, not junk food, not not drinking soda, because like with my cat last week, he was so sick. And really, no matter how much money you have, how amazing and how many cars you have, how many things you have, like if you don't have your health, you have nothing, really. Seriously, like health is life, it's a life force, and without health we have nothing. Like my grandmother used to say, my Polish grandmother who was a farmer, health is the greatest wealth. And it is, and she was my greatest inspiration in my life and in my cooking, and of course my mom too. But my grandmother, I mean, she was an amazing cook. Hi Bill, you here? Okay, so here is the thing I'm gonna, let's see, I'm just gonna make some room. Okay, you don't want to say hi to everybody? Come say hi. People want to say hi to you.
Hi,
Let
I'm
me
saying
see.
hi.
Hi.
I'm not on a microphone though.
People can hear you. I don't know if people, I don't know if anybody's saying
Pasta.
Italiana.
Hey.
You Italian, so you love
Hey.
pasta, yes?
I do.
And why you love pasta?
Because it's
I'm just,
yummy.
I don't know what I did. So I'm just looking if people are putting any comments. So yeah, Bill loves pasta. Okay, so let me see. So for this recipe, of course I'm gonna change it something because that's the way I cook. Like I never follow the recipe, but today I'm trying to follow the recipe. But the recipe calls for macadamia nuts. I don't have any macadamia nuts. They closed the store, organic grocery store by
Mrs.
us, Mrs.
Greens.
Green's, which I'm really sad. And because we had the situation with the cat, and then the whole weekend I was monitoring the cat because my other cat was hissing at him. And which we didn't know, apparently when one cat goes to the vet and comes home, the other cat feels frightened and is hissing and was really bad. So I had to like, be really following the two cats. So I didn't have time to go like to Whole Foods or something to buy raw macadamia nuts. And I'm out of cashews. But then you know what? That's okay. I'm gonna use some almonds. I'm gonna show you how easily you can substitute things. So you can use pinoli nuts, you can use Brazil nuts. I think I have some Brazil nuts, but I think I'm gonna use some almonds. You can use some walnuts, whatever nuts you want for the sauce, for the white sauce.
What's this?
And these are sun-dried tomatoes. So I already, so this is for the red sauce. So I already soaked the tomatoes. So these are unsalted, organic sun-dried tomatoes. Let's see, I'm gonna be blending it. Do you want to like show them the recipe? So here,
Sorry, yeah, they can't really see the book, it's too
yeah,
bright.
here I think is better. So let's see.
You can see that.
So I'm actually,
It's probably hard to read.
yeah, but that's
It's not
okay.
really.
I will post the recipe. But so here are the sun-dried tomatoes, and I'm actually gonna use the water that is gonna help to blend. I don't know where to place this so people can see
See what?
the Vitamix. Hold on, because you're blocking me. Like here?
Yeah, that'll be
Here?
good.
Is that good?
That's good.
Okay, so again, a recipe calls for macadamia nuts. You can use cashews too, but I'm out of both, so I'm going to be using some almonds. Now, this is the question that I get asked a lot about soaking the nuts. To soak the nuts or not soak the nuts. So, it all depends on your digestion. When you're soaking the nuts, like for example, if you were going to make almond milk, you definitely need to soak almonds like 8 hours or overnight because almonds are hard. You don't really need to soak cashews or macadamia nuts. For some people, maybe soaking the nuts is better because you know they're not used to, you know, because the nuts could be a little bit heavy for some people to digest. Like I'm eating so clean for so many years that for me it doesn't matter. I can eat a bunch of nuts and I love nuts and I go crazy for nuts, but nuts are a little bit fattening, so you know that's why I need to control myself because I could eat a lot of nuts. And I have squirrels who come here to the kitchen during the day and they ask for nuts. Like they're so funny. I have 3 squirrels. But so yeah, I didn't soak them. So I'm just gonna use them. How much was it? Just like it is. But you could soak them. Hold on. I just lost the recipe. Here I have another recipe, rosicchini pasta with pesto sauce, so you can use it and you can use the zucchini noodles. In the summertime, my favorite one is a strawberry pasta with strawberries and coconut and banana. It's delicious. It's like a dessert. You can put mangoes, you can put blueberries, whatever sauce you like. So yeah, and this. It's amazing when we had the cooking class, mango stew again with the zucchini. Actually, my friend's daughter really thought that this was cheese, that the mango sauce was cheese. She loved it. She couldn't eat enough, and this is like her favorite recipe. So that's the best thing about the zucchini because zucchini and squash and cucumber has a lot of water, so it's very low fat, you know. So you can eat a lot of that, and you're not gonna feel bad, and you're not gonna gain in a lot of weight. But you know, don't put a lot of nuts because again, nuts, you know, are a little bit fattening. So depending, you know, you can just use a lot of tomatoes. So do I have any more pastas? Oh yeah, and I have one more pasta for fall with pumpkin. So in my book, you have a lot of different pasta recipes. Another thing, what you can do if you want to have something warmer, you can make the pasta and actually put it in a dehydrator like for a few hours, and then when you take it out, it's kind of gonna marinate it, and it's gonna even taste more like kind of cooked pasta. So if you transition and you know this kind of pasta would be too raw for you, that's what you can do. Put it in the dehydrator. So dehydrator you can use for you know cooking things, but actually you can use for warming things too, which I have a recipe for pizza here, so you can warm up the pizza too. So it's really really great. Let's see if any questions. Hi guys, thank you so much for those who joining. And yeah, so I'm making raw pasta. So let's see. What's the okay, so 1 cup, 1 cup macadamia nuts. I'm gonna use the almonds. Again, you can soak it, you don't have to soak it. So here. And so my sauce may be not white because the almonds have the skin. Vegan probiotic. You don't have to add vegan probiotic, but you could. That's So I use this one, Flora Balance. It's from Dr. O'Hara, so 1 teaspoon. So if you make raw cheese, which for those who never watched my cooking class, is the first cooking class before Thanksgiving, I was making cheese. So now I'm making more like a ricotta cheese. I wanted to have this kind of feeling. Black pepper, a pinch of black pepper. Where's my black pepper? Yeah, and everybody's pinch is different, but I love black pepper. Okay, so some black pepper, pink Himalayan crystal salt, 1/4 teaspoon. So again, you do you want some a snack?
Me?
Yeah, you want some banana popsicles?
Yeah.
From last week, we can show them how they look. And chili pepper or cayenne pepper. I'm gonna put some cayenne pepper or chili, whatever you want. Cayenne pepper is so good, and chili in the winter time. Now here in New York, we have winter. We actually had some first snow, a little bit snow last night, because it's very warming for the stomach. And nutritional yeast and the lemon juice. Okay, so nutritional yeast. So nutritional yeast, it's great. So here, this is from, this one is from Bragg. This one is from this different company, Egyptian something. And so it's, it has vitamin B12, and it really has like a cheesy flavor. So for me, that was kind of the most concern going vegan, is because I used to, when I was vegetarian for many years, I used to love cheese. And this is really awesome. It really makes the cheese taste like, I mean, nut cheese. You can make cheese from nuts. You can make cheese from seeds, pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds, hemp seeds. So you can use this, and it really gives you this cool flavor. And you can put as much as you want. So what else? You want a popsicle before you go?
Okay.
And the lemon juice.
Okay.
No?
Yeah, I do. I'll
okay. So let's see. I'm gonna have to disconnect this, and I have to put some lemon juice. And they did have a lemon, but what happened? How much lemon? 1 tablespoon lemon. Or you can put the lime. I already have half cut lime. So here I want to show you my two favorite tools. So this is, of course, to squeeze the limes and lemons. And this is to squeeze grapefruits. So you can have fresh juice, like, you know, orange grapefruit juice. And for those, again, who are asking me about juicers, some people are asking me about juicers because maybe they want to get for Christmas some juicers. So I think the second Raw Vegan Cooking class I did, I talk about juicers, but there are so many different kind of juicers, and really it depends on the price, you know, what's your price range, because they start from like $70 and can go to thousands of dollars, $5,000. I think Norwalk juicer is like $4,000. My juicer, Angel juicer, was $1,500 or $1,600. You know, so you know, there is a Green Star, is a great juicer, and Omega. Omega juicer is very, very good too. So, but then Breville mixed juicer, Cuisinart. So I'm just gonna put a little bit, because I like lemony flavor. So and because I didn't soak the almonds, I may have to put a little bit more water, because let's see if it's gonna blend. It's a little, because the almonds, because if I was going to use the macadamia nuts, they would have been a little bit softer than almonds, and I didn't soak them, so I'm gonna put a little bit of water. So again, when you're cooking, just, you know, substitute. And what did I do? Of course, I messed up my recipe. What I did, I put sun-dried tomatoes and the macadamia nuts together. So now I'm not gonna have two separate colors. I'm basically making the same. Oh, I'm silly. Because I'm talking to you, I mixed in the two sauces, the ingredients from the red sauce. I mixed it already with the white sauce. So, you know, my pasta is not gonna look so pretty. Like, I'm not gonna have two colors, because basically I'm making it all together. So, fresh basil. I need some fresh basil. Just want to show you. So in the summertime, I have my fresh herbs on my patio, but in the wintertime, I bring them. My basil is getting a little bit dry because, you know, from the heat, but I love to have fresh herbs, you know, so I don't have to buy it. So I know that, you know, they are really fresh. Mm, smells so good. I'm going to put some fresh basil. So how are you guys? Hi, guys. Thank you for joining. Have to put a little bit more water. And if you don't have sun-dried tomatoes, of course you can use some regular tomatoes. Actually, I'm gonna maybe do that so have more sauce, because now basically I am not making two colors because I mixed it all together. I'm gonna put some goji berries. So any questions? What are your plans for Christmas, guys? Of course, we're gonna put some garlic and goji berries. I love goji berries. Goji berries are superfoods. They're so good. For those who are watching last week, I added them to my chocolate. I put them on my banana popsicles with the chocolate. They are so, so good. And you can put some bead, but my bead that I had, actually it's a popsicle, like a, what do you call, not a popsicle, winter... Bill, what do you call that?
Popsicle?
No, not a popsicle, but what do we call when the candy cane?
The
it looks like candy cane beads, so it's not gonna give me much color. So hold on. What I did, I mixed two sauces.
Okay, bumping them. Yeah.
Hold on. I mixed the two sauces, so now I'm not gonna have two colors. Do you understand what I did?
Yeah, I saw that happen.
Yeah, because I was talking, but it's okay.
Silly.
It's okay. So yes, popsicle. So let's... You want to go check if anybody's commenting anything?
Go.
No, no, go over there, and then I'm going to give you the popsicle.
You want it over here?
Yeah, I want to try.
What am I going to do now?
Check if you have to, like, refresh if anybody's... Okay, so
well,
let's see.
Good. I think it's all good.
Mmm, so good.
I thought I was getting a popsicle.
You are. Am I have tomato sauce or no?
No.
No. Okay, so let's show them.
I want durian ice cream.
Yeah, that's coming next.
Wow.
Where is that camera? So here are my last week I was showing you how to make raw chocolate. Am I showing right?
Yeah, put it under the camera.
So here are my raw chocolates with the natural sprinkles. So if you want to learn how to make it, you can find out in my cookbook how to make natural food coloring, or you can watch the streaming from last week. So this is from the blue tea from Thailand, and then also you can use the blue magic from Ifri Life. They also, it's a seaweed. So you're eating, stealing the chocolate, and it has gojis. So show them the gojis, superfood. And here,
yummy,
yummy. And here are the. So this is so great about like my desserts and light desserts. Here, so you know, you make the popsicles with bananas. Look how cool. And then you put them in the container and you have it. So when your kids or when your husband wants a snack, healthy snack, you have a healthy snack. So you may have to get a You may have to get a plate because
it may... Strong. It's good.
So why? It's too dark?
No, it's good.
Here. I'm giving you... Here. Can I try?
Mm-hmm.
Mmm. So good. See? Oh. I just... The bananas inside. Low. Mmm. So it's a little frozen, but low carb ice cream made of bananas. So good. The bananas has to be very ripe. So you have the sweetness from the banana.
Sweet.
And sweet. So good. Mmm. Show them like to this camera what you're eating.
Chocolate pops.
Made it from bananas.
Made from bananas.
Bill. Bill. You have chocolate on my face or no?
No.
Okay. So now, here is the sauce. So I messed it up. So my sauce is not going to look like this. I'm not going to have two colors because I mixed it in everything together, but I'm going to, you know what, I'm gonna maybe mix it a little bit more. I think I'm gonna put a little bit more water, guys, because the sauce is gonna thicken. So if I have some extra for tomorrow, I don't want it to be so thick. Because, you know, I use almonds instead of macadamia nuts. If I used cashews or macadamia nuts, it would have been so creamy. So here, where should I put it so they see?
You got ice cream, babe.
Hmm?
Good popsicle.
What? Here, I want to show it so they see.
Lydia, yes, I just bit it frozen.
Yeah, it's a little frozen.
But it's good. It's not too difficult. Hi, Vera.
Hi, guys. Thank you for watching. What are you doing for holidays? So here, so I'm gonna put the sauce. I need some spoon, big spoon.
I guess I know it's for dinner tonight.
Yeah, you love that.
Yeah.
But it looks. But it looks so pretty when you have the white color. And the red color. Sushi, there's my kitty. Hi. Here is my sushi who was so sick. And we're just so grateful that he's okay. Yes, I was saying before, thank you to Nahara. Okay, so. I need another spoon. Know who loves this pasta? My friend Eileen. So, and what happened, because zucchini or squash has a lot of water, as I told you, so it looks first like, you know, there is not much sauce, but like if you were gonna put this in the fridge for tomorrow, this is kind of the pasta is gonna shrink. I actually saw that they even sell this kind of noodles in Trader Joe's, so it's really great. Like you can, there's so many like healthy choices available everywhere. And so here, and of course you can sprinkle with some more nutritional yeast. Let me put some basil. You can put some fresh pepper flakes. You can, oh, I love to put some olives, sun-dried olives, Peruvian olives.
So. I'm cheating. I'm eating dessert first.
Yeah, that's okay. But this is a healthy dessert. It's a banana. So here you go, guys. Look how pretty. You want to have some?
I'm going to finish this.
Okay, so pasta italiana. As I said, in the picture, you have two colors. You have the white sauce and then the red sauce. But I was talking to you, so I mixed it all together. But anyway, it doesn't matter. It's still going to the stomach. But here, so this is done. So if you want, Bill, you can help yourself. So now you want durian? You want durian? Or you want the brownies? Or you want durian because you...
Yeah, no brownies.
It's I mean, brownies won't be ready till tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
They're going to dehydrate. Okay, so
here
is pasta. So I'm putting the pasta there if you want to help yourself. Okay? Okay, before I even move along, I want to show you this company. It's so awesome. When we were at the vegetarian festival with my cookbook in New York City in the springtime, that they had a table right next to us, banana. So great company if you want healthy snacks. Of course, you can make banana chips in a dehydrator, but if you don't have a dehydrator, awesome. They come with peanut butter, they come with coconut, all just plain. So these are actually my favorite, these and the coconut. But just want to show you, I guess I should show you here, ingredients. Organic bananas and organic banana powder. That's it. Another company that I love, toasted coconut chips. Very great for snacks. You can add it to your banana ice cream or, yeah, it's so great. Ingredients, coconut sugar, coconut sea salt.
They have a Stop and Shop.
Yeah, they have them now everywhere. So this is leftover from my coconut bacon, which is, you know, I have to make more of it. But so coconut, great. You can put different flavors. But now, last week, so my cat was sick. We were at the vet for 2 days. It was very stressful. I didn't have time to cook. So we ordered some Chinese food, and they have a lot of vegan things, you know. And with Chinese food, it comes, usually I just make food from scratch. But from time to time, you know, I don't feel bad because, you know, I eat very healthy and very clean. Those are the ingredients on the soya sauce. So you have water, salt, vegetable protein, corn syrup, caramel color, and then sodium benzonide, which is a preservative. So that's just showing you, you know, if you're eating a lot of fast food and all this kind of junk every day and you're ordering out and you're eating in the restaurants, you're eating... No matter what, it could be the healthiest restaurants, you eating, you know, all these preservatives and artificial coloring and corn syrup, which is usually GMO. And, you know, there is nothing better than when you cook food at home and then you really, then you know what you're eating. And the great substitute for soya sauce will be, I just want to show you, this is what I use for the coconut bacon. Liquid, I can't find it, will be BRAC liquid aminos or coconut, or it's a coconut aminos, but I took coconut nectar from the same company. So instead of soya sauce, this is what you can use. So there are always substitute. Look and really read the labels. Because we're living in this society today. We're so addicted to all these prescription drugs, to processed food, alcohol, coffee, sugar, all this stuff. And, you know, and then we're wondering why we're not feeling so good. Why are we waking up in the morning and we're feeling sluggish? Because, you know, we're eating all this stuff. And because you're going to a health food store and because something says organic and vegan, it doesn't mean it's healthy. You can have organic chips and they're not healthy. So really read your labels. And if you don't understand the labels, there's probably, you know, a chance that there are preservatives. Because usually, like here, you can clearly understand. You don't have to be a scientist to understand the ingredients. But the more ingredients, more than 8 ingredients on the label, that means, you know, it's... And the ingredients that you can't understand, I will say probably don't buy it. It doesn't matter that it came from health food store. And that's why, you know, all these companies, the food industry, they're playing with us because now they know for the last few years, you know, we like eating organic, we like eating, you know, healthy or gluten-free or fat-free. And, you know, they packaging this, you know, and people, the company is spending millions of dollars, you know, to present it to us, appealing to us, but that doesn't mean that it's healthy. So be your own, you know, be smart, you know, read the labels, teach your children how to cook, grow a garden, have, you know, some herbs at home. Those are little steps that you can do, because otherwise we are a product. We are the product of this, you know, of the world, of for these companies. Every dollar that you spend, I know people, so many people were upset with the election here in the United States about the president. Yes, you know, president can make a difference, but really you are in control of your life. Every day, every dollar you spend, you make a difference. See, I like to spend the money. I like to support local farmers. Mike's Organics delivery, I get it every week. You know, Miami fruits from Florida. I go to farmers market and I really read my labels. So be very smart. Be very, very smart, because your health depends on it. Your life depends on it. And yeah, so I just, you know, needed to say this, because now it's, I know, Christmas time, a lot of times, you know, Hanukkah, all these holidays, the end of the year, people celebrating, buying gifts, you know, so, you know, where are you spending your money? And every day, you know, every day should be, you know, the best day of your life. It's not just because it's your birthday or holiday or special occasion. Every day should be the best day. Every day you should wake up and enjoy. And should actually is not a good word. We should even actually delete the word should. It's like, do you want to? Like, what's on your path? Like, what, why are you doing something that you're doing, you know? Like, because you want to feel good, you know, because there's nothing better than feeling good. Because when we feel good, we can help our kids, we can help, you know, be good at our job, we know, we can help other people, we have compassion. When we feel crappy, cranky, and not good, then you know, it's just, we can't do anything. So just invest in your health. And it's not selfish. It's being, you know, this is like, you know, being actually assertive. Take care of your health. And then you're going to be, you know, so happy. So okay, now I'm moving along to durian. I think my husband wants some durian. Let's see if anybody's posting anything. Yeah, you love those coconut, those are great, and they actually come with salt ones. So yeah, read the ingredients. And so here, let me move all this stuff. I need to get a better cutting board so we can see what I'm doing. So for durian pudding, you need, it's very hard to open Thai coconuts. You know, you can get like a machete knife. And if you've been to like Thailand, like I've been to Thailand, I've been to Jamaica and Mexico, and these guys, you know, they just and open the coconut, and it's so easy. Like, be careful. There are some videos on YouTube that you can follow how to open it, but I just invested in a Coco Jack, which, so this is my durian pudding. That's what we're making. This is my favorite thing ever. So today is my name's day, so this is gonna be my cake. This is even better than the cake. I love this. So, let's see. Where is my Coco Jack? I got this tool like few Christmases ago, and this is the best. It's made in the United States. It's amazing, and it actually comes with the little scooper. So you have the hammer, and then you have the tool. Before I had this, I used to like use the hammer and the screwdriver, and I used to, because I was afraid, because I'm kind of clumsy sometimes, so I was afraid to like using the machete. Although I have very good professional knives, I was afraid to cut the coconut because I was afraid I'm gonna cut myself. So I used to do like the screwdrivers to make a hole, and then and drink the coconut water, and then make few holes, and then it pops. But this is so much easier. I'm gonna show you. So here I have some. Coconuts, if you don't have, so these are Thai coconuts, these are not like the hairy coconuts. And now they sell the meat from the coconuts, like in health food stores, like in, I know, Whole Foods sells them, it's frozen, so you can, you know, buy it and you can use for so many desserts. You can actually make wraps. In my cookbook, I have, I think, beet wrap, but you can use for so many different things. It's so delicious. You can put in your smoothies. It's amazing. So here, let's see. If you don't have a coconut, you can use coconut milk, or you can just use water. But of course, it's gonna get taste so much better. Fresh coconut water. There is nothing better than than fresh coconut water. When you're sick, when you have like upset stomach or, you know, indigestion, diarrhea, when you sunburn, you know, when you were on the sun or something, nothing will give you. This is like a natural Gatorade, electrolyte, like natural coconut water. It's amazing. Actually, in many countries or even in this country, sometimes they even give raw coconut water intravenously if somebody's very sick because it has so many, you know, benefits. So it's so good. So here I'm going to. So this is what you do. It's gonna be a little noisy. Is it coming? Oh, no, it didn't. Uh-oh. Hold on. Whoa. This coconut clearly. Whoa, it's like spilling, like open. So here, look, guys. I don't know if you can see it. Of course, my phone is ringing. I have like coconut all over me, so I don't know if the where's the video, but here. So this is the coconut meat and this is the water. So before before you pour the coconut water, always check it because from time to time you can get like a bad one, you know, like sometimes you get a bad apple. So just make sure, because you know they do come from like Thailand or Philippines. Oh, so good. So make sure that you know you have the good coconut. It's so amazing. If it's hot, this is like nothing better than like drinking the fresh coconut. So here and this one, depending on the coconut, like sometimes it has very little meat, and sometimes has a lot. So this one has a lot, and this coco jack comes with the tool, but I don't know where I put it, and somewhere in that drawer behind me. The house is shaking, yes. So I'm just gonna use a spoon. So now I'm gonna be opening durian. We also need to have some medjool dates. These are so good, organic medjool dates for sweetener. See your medjool dates. And if you don't have a coconut meat, and I said if you don't have a fresh coconut, you can use coconut butter, which is like a peanut butter but made of coconut. It's so delicious, so you can use coconut butter. And we're going to use some frozen banana too, and some my favorite vanilla, medicine flower vanilla. So okay, so here is durian. So this is pretty small durian. So durian, it's a stinky fruit. It's called the king of fruits. So I know some people were very excited last week, but I didn't have a chance to go to durian. So this is an acquired taste. So first time, I don't know how many years ago, we went to Thailand. I had durian in Thailand, and no, I had it before we went to Thailand. My friend Lillian introduced us to durian, and we were not so crazy about it, but then in Thailand we liked it. So it's like a stinky cheese. The more you like it, the more you eat it, the more you like it. My friend Ashley, I think she's tried it 3 times and she still doesn't like it. So maybe you won't like it, but I love it. This is like my favorite fruit. Has a lot of benefits, a lot of that's why it's called King of Fruit, because you have to be very careful because it has very sharp minerals, vitamins, amino acids. It's great. So here is breaking, so you have to be. So these come from probably Thailand, so they are frozen. So when you buy them, they're not as smelly, but if you go to Thailand and you buy the fresh one, they are more smelly. And sometimes you can even buy them like frozen, already picked. So So you need a sharp knife to open durian. Let me wash my hands. Oh, don't let me forget, because some people are asking me about natural skincare, so I want to show you what I use. So here, any questions? Let's see. So this is a small durian. So usually how you open the durian, it has like pockets that you can, sometimes they just open by itself, but I don't know if you can see it. Like here, it has like pockets. So I'm going to try to open this one. You have to be very careful. And this one, it was very still frozen. So it could be, yeah, it's just, it could be still frozen inside. My husband went to H Mart and let's see. Sometimes you just like see, pull it and they open, but it's still kind of frozen, so it doesn't want to, it didn't fall, so, whoa, I may have to open the whole durian. Bill? Yeah, I can't open like nicely for you because I have to cut it in half because this durian, it's very, it's still a little frozen. Oh, it's a work, I tell you, when you eat a lot of raw vegan food, it's a workout to bring all these fruits and veggies. So here, when you, yeah, you can, it's still like a little frozen. So when you try this, it kind of tastes to me like a vanilla pudding. So I'm just gonna, you can actually put even the pits too, but I'm not going to. Yeah, it's very frozen. Yay. So how, where do you buy durian? Any like Asian supermarket. So if you have any Asian, Korean supermarket, they have them like in the fruit section. Or you may have to ask them, they may have it in the freezer in the back. Yeah, it's so frozen inside. See, I can't even open it. Usually just opens like easily. I'm just trying to cut him in half so it will be easier to. This guy doesn't want to. Kind of look like an alien inside. See, it's so frozen. Usually, just want to show you. See, like how easily, like these pockets, they just peel, but it's because it's still frozen. It doesn't want to do that. You can smell here all the way, Lydia. Yes, I know you love durian. I wish you lived closer. Yeah, I introduced Lydia to durian. See, I can't even start coming a little bit, but it's kind of like I'm going into like a brain or something. That's how I feel. But this durian is very, see, it doesn't want to open easily. See, usually, look, see how easily it just pulls, but because it was frozen and didn't want to do it. So here, okay, so I'm just gonna make it, I'm not gonna use the whole thing. Because I know Bill wants to eat it. Here. Here, one more piece. So you can keep, like, you can, this is a small one, but you can cut half and then keep one in the fridge for a few days because it was frozen. You know, I mean, not for a long, long time, but so you don't have to eat the whole thing at once. My other favorite fruit, which you can buy in the health food stores, jackfruit. Oh my God. And they had such a yummy one in Jamaica. Let me just wash my hands. So the recipe calls for frozen bananas, but because my durian it's, I'm gonna put some dates. My durian, it's already frozen, so I'm not gonna even use frozen bananas, just regular bananas. But you, if it's really hot in the summer, just put, you know, frozen bananas, but I don't want it to be too cold because, you know, it's cold in New York. So here, some dates, some gooey dates, and some vanilla, and I'm gonna put some coconut. So I'm just gonna use the spoon. So look, see how easily just pops. This one has a lot of, and you don't have to put the coconut meat if you like want to keep it low fat. Just gonna cut this off. In my cookbook, I have a recipe how to make a raw coconut yogurt. So actually you use the Thai coconuts and you make your coconut yogurt with probiotic, and it's so delicious. Maybe I'll show you next week, but you can also use cashews. So it's very easy. You can make your own cheese from nuts and seeds. You can make your own yogurt. You can, you know, there's so many things that you can make it at home. Because again, when you buy yogurt in the store, many times they have some, you know, preservatives and stuff, because they want them to last a long time. So here, let me just move these tools. Okay. And the banana. Oh, if you don't have coconut butter, you can even use shredded coconuts. And here. I don't want to eat a lot of it, so. This actually gives you energy. It's amazing. Like, fruits gives you a lot of energy. And especially this one, durian. So I'm just going to put two bananas. I'm not going to put three. And so here. Can you see? Forgot my plunger. Of course, we need this because we don't want to break the Vitamix. I mean, although Vitamix is very strong, but oops, you know, it's bumping the camera, so I have to move it. So good. Here, guys, see? Yummy. Let's see. I know my husband loves this. You can put some raw chocolate over, some sprinkles. It's delicious. It's raw. Yummy pudding. It tastes really like a vanilla pudding, so. me give Bill a teaspoon now. Bill, your durian is ready, so here you go. Shall we put some blue sprinkles on it? You can put some fresh fruits. So here are my blue sprinkles that I made it before. Here, look how pretty. And you can put some goji berries, and there you go. Yummy. Bill's gonna be so happy. So for those who just joined, we made some raw pasta. And look, I'm gonna show you. See how pasta is like shrinking because all the water, it's, you know, it seems like the sauce is getting more watery. So we made the pasta italiana, durian pudding. And now I'm going to be making brownies. Oh yeah, and huge congratulations to my friend Ashley and Shane who had a baby, for those who were watching last week. So yeah, Ashley had a baby, beautiful baby, Lily Jade. So congratulations to Lily. And I mean, congratulations to Ashley and Shane, because you have Lily. I can't wait to meet her when I go to Vegas. Okay, now let's see if anybody's commenting. Where can you buy the jackfruit, Annetta? Yes, so jackfruit you can buy also at Whole Foods stores like Korean, Asian, Chinese stores. And if you don't have the fresh one, many times they sell dry fruit, jackfruit. And actually you can get it from Miami Fruits. The farm, organic farm from Miami, that I ordered this delicious organic fruits. They have jackfruit and durian. They grow durian and a jackfruit. So if you can buy it, contact them. I don't know if it's seasonal, but they sell durian and jackfruit. And it's so good. Okay, so the pasta is made from raw squash. And the recipe comes from my cookbook, Raw Food Art. But I also have a lot of recipes on my website, olenkoskitchen.com. But this one, I put some sun-dried tomatoes. I put some regular tomatoes. I put some goji berries and some, you can put cashew nuts or macadamia nuts. I didn't have any, so I used some almonds. And I put some basil and I forgot to put garlic, but you can add some garlic. You know, when you're cooking sometimes and I'm talking to you, I get distracted. But yeah, you can put some garlic, you can put some onion, you can put whatever spices you want. It's really, really good. And so now the last thing that I'm going to show you today, and then if I have any time, I can open for questions. So if you have any questions, let me know. What time is it? Oh yeah, I have time. Bill, your durian. So here, let me put this away. So why don't you move him? Yeah, my husband said my cat Sushi, who was sick, it's sleeping on his lap. So here, let's see. I have the recipe for brownies. So these brownies are so good. I love them. And let's see, where is the recipe? The recipe is actually on my website too. So cashew banana brownies. I don't have any cashew meal, but I have almond meal. Or do I have a cashew meal? But if you don't have almond meal flour, so you can make it yourself. So how you make cashew or almond milk, there are two ways. So you can blend the cashews or the almonds in the food processor or even in the Vitamix or blender, like dry. Or when you're making almond milk or cashew milk and then you have the leftover pulp, you can put it in a dehydrator and then you have the flour. So there's two ways you can do it, or you can just buy it. So I just had it at home. As I said, I'm a little bit low on everything because we had this emergency with our cat last week. And so this is what I'm gonna need. So I need 3 caps cashew meal. Okay. You can buy these in a Whole Foods store. Just make sure that this that are unbleached almonds, that you have raw almonds. So let's see, 3 cups. So it's very easy to substitute if you don't have something. Is this 3 cups? Yeah, perfect. 3 cups. Okay, and now I need 2 cups of 4 large bananas, 2 cups of raw cacao powder. So this is raw cacao. And for those, you know, who were watching last week, I spend a lot of time talking about benefits of raw cacao, how amazing it is. It has a lot of magnesium, potassium, iron, and this is superfood. And so because I'm going to be using a dehydrator, so the temperature is going to be below 118 degrees. So everything that I'm making today, it's raw food. So why are we eating raw food? Because we have the life force, which is the enzymes, you know, the life force. Think about when something grows, when the plants grow and they actually start from seeds. And I've been doing about class about sprouting, the amazing benefits of sprouting. So, you know, the little sprout pops and then, you know, it grows and then there's a little mini sprout and then it grows bigger, you know, and it starts in the soil and then, you know, the energy, is going into the sun. If you ever follow, you know, if you ever saw how plants grow, even like sunflowers, they will actually turn the head of the sunflower, will follow the sun throughout the day, like will completely turn, which is amazing. So, so the life force, you know, from the sun and from the soil, from the earth, from the rain, from all these elements, which we are part of the nature. So if we follow, you know, the kind of the pathways of nature, and if we're eating fresh, organic, beautiful fruits and vegetables and plants, you know, we're going to feel so good. So that's why eating raw food, you know, as much as we can is very beneficial. And yes, again, I am not 100% raw. I still eat some cooked food because I actually feel like for my body, you know, eating some cooked quinoa, like today I had some quinoa or some soup or some brown rice. I actually like the philosophy of microbiotic diet, you know, some sea vegetable, cooking, you know, so it works with me. So I eat some cooked food, so I don't eat 100% raw, just, you know, to be sure. But yeah, so eat some salad, even simple salad, a simple wrap here. And if you don't have a dehydrator, you can always put the lower setting of your oven, and then it depending, you know, maybe it will be just a few hours, but this definitely needs to be dehydrated. Otherwise, if you were gonna put this in this brownie, brownies, I'm gonna show you here, then you will they will be kind of like very wet, and we want it to have that gooey feeling. So can you see this? I don't know, because before I had the pasta. So here, 2 cups of raw cacao. And if somebody for some reason is allergic to caffeine, because raw cacao has caffeine, perfect, 2 cups. You can use some carob powder, you know, because carob, it's very good. It's actually a legume. Or you can mix half and half if you don't want it to be too strong, to show you. So all natural carob powder. So you can do like 50-50 or... Okay, what else? What do I need? So this is the best thing about raw cooking, that you can do this with kids because it's so easy. They're, you know, you can't burn yourself, you're not using an oven, you're not using a fire, so anybody can do this. So I strongly invite that you practice this with your kids. You know, you make some smoothies, use some raw chocolate or something. It's so fun, and you know, it's very healthy. I know a lot of my clients' kids love my recipes. I know a lot of my friends, you know, from many different ages all around the world. So, you know, try it. It's so fun. And experiment and create your own recipe. It's so, so awesome. Okay, so lucuma powder. So what is lucuma? Lucuma, it's a fruit from Peru, but again, if you don't have lucuma, it's sweet, so that's why I'm using it. You can just put more, you can just use more sweetener, but this is just naturally sweet. 1 cup lucuma, it's really delicious. I have this recipe on my website for lucuma ice cream, which is so good with bananas. And what did I do? Am I going, oh, here. It's right in the front of my eyes. And I'm looking for my measuring. Okay, so 1 cup. Cinnamon, 1 teaspoon of cinnamon. Okay. I love this company, Frontier. This is my favorite company for spices, organic. But now if even Mr. McCormick, they have organic spices, so it's great. So one, I love cinnamon. Cinnamon, again, like cayenne pepper, it's so good in the winter season. You know, it's very good for our root chakra, which is the base, you know, the red chakra, you know, the base of the chakras. It's very grounding. It's very, you know, keep our digestion warm. It gives us the energy, you know, that we need in the winter time. So pink Himalayan Christian salt, one teaspoon and 4 bananas. Let's see if anybody's commenting. Hi guys, thank you so much for those who join. And let me know if you have any questions. So 2 cups filtered water. No vanilla? You can put, of course, some vanilla. I guess I didn't put vanilla. Two cups filtered water, and I have to smash some bananas. So when you're using bananas, make sure they are ripe. This is four large bananas. This could have been even riper, but now it's cold in New York, so bananas don't want to ripen so fast. Let's see. I'm gonna smash them. The best way to smash the bananas are to use the potato smasher. That works for me. So you can use many tools in your kitchen. You can use like multi-purpose them. Okay. So these brownies are so good, and you can add some dry fruits. Again, you make sure that you look at the ingredients, that the dry fruits that you buy have no sulfur. So they're unsulfured, that they don't have any canola oil or added sugar, because many times, even when it comes in the health food store, they do add all this different junk in it. So make sure that it just say dry fruit. So I don't have any cherries, I think, but here I'm gonna show you. So I'm just mashing the bananas. Here, I'm learning how to do it this with 2 cameras. So I'm mashing. And I'm gonna put maybe some mulberries. I love mulberries. And you can put some pecans in the brownies, whatever you want. Walnuts, hazelnuts. So these are gluten-free. Mostly all the raw stuff is gluten-free. So here. I'm What are you guys doing for? Are you for Christmas, for holidays? Are you done with your like Christmas shopping? I didn't do anything yet. I'm so behind. But you know what? I truly believe that holidays should be the time to relax, enjoy, take a nap. Because think of an animals, like here now in New York is winter. Many animals hibernate, and they, you know, they sleep, and just naturally, we just want to rest. And many times, you know, we don't give ourselves permission to rest. We're always busy, busy, going. So I just have to mix now everything. You can of course use a food processor to mix it, but I'm just gonna use my hands. And I did use 2 cups of raw cacao because I love raw cacao. I love chocolatey things, but again, you can use less. And let's see, I may have to mix this. So see, it's like, it's getting very thick, kind of like a brownie mix. So again, I never tried it putting this in the oven, but I'm sure. No, I feel bad. I think my husband is upstairs because my cat is sleeping on him. Let me bring him my durian ice cream. I'll be right back, guys. Now it works?
Yeah.
Okay, I think I'm back. Can you hear me now, guys?
I can definitely hear you.
Okay, can you hear me? Because what happened? Battery
dead
died.
Batteries.
Okay, so.
Dead batteries.
Okay. Happened. So, see now the brownies are getting. So I have to mix it. Yeah, using food processor will be very good, but I don't want to bring my food processor here. And I need to put some maple syrup. That's why. Because maple syrup is going to make everything more wet. See, this is what happened when I'm talking to you guys. I'm forgetting. So it says 4 tablespoons of maple syrup. That's why it doesn't want to mix. I knew something wasn't right. 1, 2, 3. So you can, so if you don't have lucuma powder, you would just use more maple syrup, or you will use, you can use like coconut sugar. Here is coconut sugar or coconut nectar. You can use some coconut sugar or coconut nectar instead of maple syrup. So this is raw. But I love the flavor of maple syrup. It's like my favorite flavor. I love the coconut nectar too. It's not as sweet, so you use a little bit more. And you can also use some dates sugar too. See, now it mixes very easy. So, you know, you always have to... Oh, you can hear me now. Yay! So here, I'm going to put some... So now, see, it's nice and gooey. And I'm going to put some mulberries. Let's see. Raisins. So you can put some mulberries and raisins. How much? Cherries. I don't have any cherries, but I'm gonna put some cherries. Again, just want to show you this golden sun-dried raisins. Look, there's nothing. Oh, what does it say? Look at the ingredients. No oil, no. No added sugar or anything, because many times that's what they do. They add stuff. So now, depending how you want your brownies, how thick you want them to be, you can put in different dish. I was gonna use this dish, but I don't know. Let's see. This one maybe is better. I don't know which one is bigger. I think maybe this one. No, these are small. Yeah, I may have to use two.
I'm vegetarian.
Okay, so you can entertain everybody.
Why?
No, because I'm just like, I may have to do both.
I'm entertaining.
You're entertaining? You're dancing?
Yes.
You're funny.
There's no frozen bananas in it, though.
No, because durian was so frozen. Mm. So, yeah, I put it just because I couldn't even cut it. I don't know if you saw it. So now we're going to put parchment paper. So it doesn't, so it's easier for us to, You love it? Yeah, I love some durian too. So I'm going to use some parchment paper. I should move it there so they can see what I'm doing, yes? What?
Something's frozen.
What?
I don't know if it's your iPad or computer's not frozen. I will check.
My iPad. Is it working or no?
I don't know.
I don't know, you don't see anything. Okay, it works. So here, guys, I'm gonna show you. Can you see this? So these brownies, this is what is going to happen. They're probably gonna go in a dehydrator like overnight. And then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take them out of the dish. And then, this dish is kind of small. And then I'm gonna cut them and then put them on the sheet, so mesh sheet, so they can dry faster. So here, you can of course spread that some coconut or whatever you want. Some.
It's yummy.
It's yummy.
But I have to say, I like it with the frozen bananas. It's my favorite.
Okay.
But it's good. It's really good. But yeah. It's good to know, you know?
No, I mean, I know, but it would have been hard for me to freeze it.
I understand. So. It's really good, though.
Okay, so here are the brownies. I'm going to show you. So this is what I made. So now they're going to go in the... I'm not going to put the dehydrator. So I'm going to take everything out of my dehydrator, and I'm going to put it on the bottom. And overnight, they're going to be there for probably, 110 degrees for 6-8 hours until they're firm. And then I will take them out. Then I will take them out of the paper and cut them and put them on the individually on the sheets. And then they will dry. And also what you can do if you really love chocolate, you can make some raw chocolate and put it on the top. And it's so good. And this is so good with like raspberry sauce. And it's really, really good. Yes, those are delicious. So I'm using almond flour, almond meal, but you can use cashew meal. So any question, guys? Let's see. What are you eating? Durian. He's eating durian.
Who asked?
Roger.
Oh, Roger. What's up, Raj?
We have half durian left. So this is durian pudding. This is what we made. We made brownies, durian pudding.
Durian is a Thomas Asian fruit.
It's an Asian superfood, king of fruits.
We got an H Mart phone.
We got it at H Mart. And here we have some pasta. Look at pasta, so gooey pasta. And it's so, so good.
What's it made of?
It's made of raw zucchini or squash. Today I use organic squash and some sun-dried tomatoes. And you can use some macadamia nuts or cashews. I use some almonds today. And then I put some goji berries. It's really delicious. And any questions? We have a little bit of time.
What's up, Raj? He thought it was whipped cream.
Oh, okay. It looks kind of like whipped cream. I know some people were asking me about what I use for skincare. So I was wondering if anybody is interested, then maybe one class I will do like cooking class, and in part I will do some beauty tips, you know, how to make some natural tips. You beautiful as it is.
Roger says I'm the king.
You're so beautiful. Yes, you're the king. So here is some natural body hand cream that I made. Face cream. It smells so good with essential oils. So what I did, I melted some raw shea butter and coconut oil. And then I added some essential oils. The company that I use, it's called Young Living. This is dessert oatmeal, but this is your dessert. He's eating dessert first before pasta. And you can put some orange. I put some, these are Vitality line. You can use it in the food, so you can actually put it in the food. I could even put it in the brownies. Maybe I will put some in the brownies because I have two kinds. And
Roger says he uses coconut oil.
For what?
I guess.
Oh, for moisturizer. Awesome. So yeah, so this has coconut oil and shea butter. You can also put some avocado oil too. So I melted on a very low heat, kind of like making raw chocolate. I put it, and then you can actually whip with the hand blender if you want it more like a whipped cream. Whipped one. And then this is great for dry hands. My hands are so dry. I'm always washing my hands, working with kids at my job, and then, you know, being in the kitchen, and also because, you know, it's winter time, our skin gets very dry. Another company. What's so funny?
He wants to know if you run
what
He wants to know if you rub the special oil on King Bill.
Yeah, I rub the special oil on King Bill. But this company, for my face, you know, for my makeup, I used to work as a makeup artist for many years for Clinique. And so I love this company, Tartan. Not everything, unfortunately, that Tartan makes, it's vegan and cruelty free, but a lot of them are. So I love these mascaras. So Tarte is a great company that for those who, I just got a package from them. For those who are wondering, Pacifica is another company. Pacifica that make great organic vegan makeup, eyeshadows and everything. So Tarte, here I have some chopstick. And then I also love Josie Moran. Josie Moran has a lot of stuff. It's vegan and organic, and everything is with argan oil. So I love, this is Josie Moran stuff. So yeah, but you can use some natural, make some natural makeup. I have some natural makeup I got from Morocco, from Poppies actually. So if you're interested, write it in the comments, and maybe one day I will do like a cooking class with beauty class and show you how to make masks and some hair stuff with essential oils, with oils and some stuff that you actually have in the kitchen. I can show you how to make toothpaste and mouth hair dry shampoo and even hairspray and all these different things. But yeah, make sure that everything you put on your body, everything that you put on your body and you put it inside your body is very important, because our skin is the biggest organ and we put so many toxins every day. You know, we have fluorine and chlorine and in our water, you know, and
fluoride,
that's what I mean, in our water. And we're putting all this, you know, stuff with so many chemicals or toothpaste, and then, you know, we're eating all this junk food, and then we're breathing, you know, the toxic air from the pollution, from the cars and everything, and the stress, adding on everything, stress. It's like, you know, our body is just overwhelmed with all this toxicity all around us. So being gentle for your body, really, you know, paying attention, what are you eating, what are you drinking, of course, hydrating, drinking a lot of water. I showed you last week how to make water infused with fruits and herbs, but drinking water, drinking some tea. So, you know, those simple things you can do. But yeah, read the labels and research every company, you know, that you're buying, because every dollar you spend, you're actually voting. Like, you think that you voted for the president, you're actually voting with everything, every decision that you're making, you know. And if you know, paying for all this fast food, junk food, and, you know, you're contributing to diabetes, number, you know, type 2, heart problems, obesity for our children, you know, there's so many, you know, obese children and adults too. But this is just like, especially, you know, in this country, in the United States. So, you know, be mindful. We can all teach each other. We can all, you know, help each other, support each other. So, you know, invite your neighbors, your coworkers, your friends, your family, and cook together, and, you know, go shopping together. And, you know, life's supposed to be about fun and enjoyment and, you know, feeling great. So
Roger says you have to rub the oil on my feet and give me a foot massage.
Yes.
And he says he's coming to do a guest appearance.
Yes, I can't wait.
He swears by coconut oil, and Jules is interested in making some homemade products.
Okay, awesome. So I can show you how to make homemade
products. And we have high pH water, he says.
Not today. Yes, not today. And coconut oil is great. And shea butter, raw shea butter, like from Africa, which you can buy it in health food stores. It's very thick and it's so, so good for your body. And yeah, using essential oils. I can like do the whole class about essential oils too, if people are interested. But let me see if any questions. I think that's about it. For today,
I know, I'm eating all the time.
You're eating, but it's all healthy. That's your dinner. You can eat this kind of food and you're feeling great. You know, it's guilt-free food.
Now I have to eat my pasta.
But pasta, it's like there's no carb. I mean, there are carbs, but they're healthy.
It's zucchini.
Carbs. It's from zucchini. It's made of this. So it's good pasta, you know, it's a veggie pasta.
And tomatoes.
So next week I'll be doing probably a streaming on Monday and maybe on Thursday, maybe two streamings, because on Thursday will be my last day from work, and then I'm going to be on vacation till January, so I'm going to have a little bit more time. But post in the comments if you have any interest in different topics. I'd be happy, you know, to do streaming for you. I wish I can all invite you to my house and you can all try the food, but please try making my recipes at home and post some pictures. I would be really happy to see the pictures. So today's all the three recipes were from my cookbook Raw Food Art, available on Amazon and Barnes and Nobles and many other stores worldwide. And follow me on Instagram, on Olenka's Kitchen Facebook page, and yeah, I have a YouTube. I have a lot of stuff coming and soon, so yeah, and a lot of interesting programs, and I hope this benefits for you. So thank you so much for watching. Have a good night, guys.
It's and over already?
Yeah, it's over. I mean, look, it's almost time, unless you want to hang out and eat food, but
I'm definitely gonna hang out and eat food.
Yeah, so I don't know what else to say. I've been talking for
two hours,
and tomorrow I'm gonna be teaching all day with kitties. Kitties are so excited. My students are so excited for Christmas. Oh my god. And yeah, so try to, you know, how to fit in skinny jeans during Christmas. You know, eat a lot of salads, eat a lot of fruits and vegetables. Nobody ever overdid on fruits and vegetables. Drink a lot of water, you know, take some naps, maybe go for massage, maybe relax. You know, I know this is a very busy time of the year. Everybody is, you know, busy doing, but you know, it's holidays, the end of the year. We only have like, what, 2 weeks left, 3 weeks left in this year. So, you know, celebrate, you know, and 2017 is coming. So if you didn't accomplish something, you know, don't worry about it. You're going to have a chance, you know, tomorrow you have a chance to. So go to the nature, go for a walk, and, you know, get inspired by others and be, you know, the light to the world, because, you know, that's what is more important. That's what holiday is about. It's not about presents. It's not about all these material things, but it's about the spirit. So,
thanks, Rog. Roger says he loves your show.
Oh, great. Yeah, I can't wait to have you, Roger.
And
you
he's
can,
funny. He's
you, you can guy. Talk about biking and how important, you know, physical exercise is, because it's really, really important. So, yeah, I haven't been taking any yoga because my teacher was away. She was in Hawaii, but she's coming back. So I miss my yoga. And yeah, so love you guys. And, you know, so today we made brownies, raw vegan pasta, and some durian pudding. So post in the comments what else you want to learn next week. Okay, so love you guys. Ciao. I'm going to make more brownies. Good night. Yeah, I have more brownies to make. Maybe I put some different flavor. Good night. Finish.